Race number 5 is at 4:20 and it's the Peacock Brothers Handicap over the 2,000 metres. The horse we're watching here is number 3, Thunderclap Newman, who finished 4th at Belmont on September 30.
Rella Beck still back in the field, in company with Buster Shadow sticking to the rail. Verdello Blue hit the front once again. Sonnen down the outside trying to bridge the margin. Verdello Blue, Sonnen, they're going to fight it out from Warzar. Kirov Boy at the 100. Verdello Blue, Sonnen the outside. It's Sonnen on the outside of Verdello Blue kicking back, but Sonnen gets his head in front late. And Sonnen did just a touch too well.
Sonnen the first three out were the first three home there, and Thunderclap Newman was third last on the turn, and I just really loved that last 50 metres in particular. Start prior, he ran in beside Entrechar, and we know what she did on Saturday. Of the others, I've got the one, Golgotha, in for second, produced a gritty win over the mile at Northam and is wanting the extra trip now. In for third, I've got the 7, Imperious, was trapped wide when 4 lengths fifth behind Trap for Fools over the 2200 at Northam. But his last 100 metres was very promising, and the 5, Bell Montgomery, goes in for fourth, was taken on in front and still proved too good this track and distance last start. This is a step up in grade, but there's no doubt this horse is running very well. My numbers for race number 5, the 3, Thunderclap Newman, and the 1, Golgotha, the 7, Imperious, and the 5, Bell Montgomery. Race number 6 is at 5 o'clock, and it's the Crown Perth opening day, 21 October handicap, over the 1,000 metres. The replay horse here is number 7, Resistance, finishing third at Belmont on September 23.
Noski at the top of the home straight trying to quicken as Resistance now let go by the Wizard, dashes up, and Resistance hits the lead going to the 250. Look at Aaron Boy getting out though, running on well. Money Maher further back, and then came Moshard. Aaron Boy went to Resistance at the 100 though. Down the outside, Roganella now starting to get out of the ground. Aaron Boy, Roganella diving. Aaron Boy, I think, scrambled in.
That replay just really speaks for itself, and she ticks a lot of boxes, does this filly. She pings the lids like an absolute ripper. We'll sit on speed here again, and you can be sure she'll give a kick or two in the home straight. She goes on top from the 1, Denim Pack, who wasn't disgraced when 3 lengths fifth to Cash On Call over the 1300 metres. Is a maiden winner over the 1000 the start prior, and is back to that distance here, and barrier 2 is a plus. For third, I've got the 6, Oregon Bronze, a stable mate to Resistance. Was 1 length third off Dawn Mission in solid time at Northam last time around, but it was the win over Another Story 2 starts back that really took my eye, and that run has me convinced that she's a challenger here. And in for fourth, I've got the 8, Get the Vibe, has been out sprinted in its last 3 previous runs at the 1000 metres this time in, but this is easier and is drawn ideally in barrier 4. Onto the selections for race number 6, I've got the 7, Resistance, on top from the 1, Denim Pack, the 6, Oregon Bronze, and the 8, Get the Vibe. Race number 7 is at 5:37 and it's the Western Race Picks handicap over 1650 metres. The replay horse here is number 1, Taxidermy, winning at Belmont on October the 4th.
When it gets about ahead to the good of Torte Caprizi, called upon again behind the Mine Boss. Hill looking to get clear. Down the outside, Taxidermy. Celtic Wizard not getting a lot of room at all right behind those. Searching for rails run, Cosmar Domination. Taxidermy at the 150. Quickly raced up to Noir de Rue, hit the front. Getting into the clear now, Celtic Wizard, but the bird had flown. Taxidermy, the big fellow, drew clear. Taxidermy won from...
That win came over the same track, distance and grade as what he'll face here again. Taylor Stone jumps on board for Daniel Stake this time around, which means he'll carry 1.5 kilos less. There's plenty of chances here, and the 5, Time to Hunt, is certainly one of them. I was a fan of his first up run when 4th behind Prize Catch. That was certainly tougher than this. I've got the 3, Shibuya Crossing, in for 3rd. It was wide with no cover the whole trip and still proved too good at Kalgoorlie. 1650 metres is a step up from the 1400 metres here, but that looks ideal. And in for 4th, I've got the 2, Celtic Wizard, was chopped out of a run by Taxidermy in that replay that we just saw. It is 4th up now and can get his revenge if good enough. My selections for race number 7, I've got the 1, Taxidermy, ahead of the 5, Time to Hunt, the 3, Shibuya Crossing, and the 2, Celtic Wizard. on to my two best bets for the day, and I'll start with race 5 number 3, and that is Thunderclap Newman, and race 7 number 1 Taxidermy. For comments on all of Wednesday's runners, as well as comments on some of those under the radar runners, be sure to check out our Perth Racing website or swing by our social media platforms. That's it for this edition of The Box Seat. We'll catch you next time.